What's up, YouTube? So, I decided after being let go from my last job that I'm going to start a landscape business. So, I went out and I got this trailer. And I will do a follow-up video. This is a 6x12 SA trailer. And so, what I want to do, I'm going to give a full review of this trailer and my setup, but I'm starting a lawn care business. In the last video I did, I talked about real time. That was me literally leaving from my job, which was cold. And what I want to do is just talk to you a little bit about how to start a lawn care business. I decided to go into an industry where I know there's a demand and I can make money. So what I want to show you right now is one of the things that you're going to need when you get into the lawn care business. So this little short video is about what shoes to get for lawn care and landscaping. And I put up a few images that that you'll see right here. All right, so I have to, you know, cut in for the editing, but those were the type of shoes that are hiking and boots, work boots and hiking. So something dawned on me because my history cutting grass at a golf course reminded me that some of the best waterproof shoes are golf shoes. So what I'm going to do and what I'm going to recommend right now, I'm going to test these out. But I remember this from the past. In high school, I had a job working at a local golf course. And if you ever played golf, you know one of the biggest problems, because when you play golf, you normally start in the morning and the grass is always wet. It's always wet. So golfers always have high standards for golf shoes. They demand them to be airtight, waterproof. So I went over to Dick's and I ended up picking up these Adidas. I'll give you the exact make. These are the Tour Traxxon TR. All right, and they run a little bit small. So you see I got 11.5 in Air Force Ones, you know, Nikes, I wear a 10.5. So just give you an idea, you need to get probably a size up for Adidas. And they were selling them for $99, if you can see that. But that sticker says 99. There it is, maybe you can see it. But they had them on sale. So I ended up getting a deal on that. Now, this also was a good deal for me because I saved money on the other hiking boots, because they were all of the options that I like on the hiking boots were all well over $100. And some of the Merrells, which had a lot of reviews, are $140, $160. I ended up getting everything out the door for $80. Now, let me show you one thing that's cool. These golf shoes come with really good traction by default, and these little spikes, they're soft rubber, so they have grip. They're not something that's gonna slide like a pair of football cleats. They got grip, so it's rubbery, gives you traction, and you can replace them. So for $80 is what I spent out the door. I was able to get the shoes and this little thing, which you gotta have with this, is a cleat wrench. So that you can, this little two-prong little deal right here is what you need to go in here and take these little cleats off. They come off. So you can see there's four of them there. And you can see those two little holes. I'm going to try to zoom it there. Focus it. You can see it has two holes. And that allows you to replace those. So when they wear down, then you'll be able to, you know, replace them and get more traction. So I'm going to test these out. I've used them in the past. I know they work. I had a pair of Nike golf shoes that I was using, but they were so old that the heel ended up separating and coming off. But I had used them for years. These shoes have a 2-year, maybe it's on the side of the box, but look it up on the internet. They are waterproof and they have a 2-year. Yeah, see, there it is. Has a 2-year waterproof warranty. So when you're cutting grass, the whole issue is that you need your feet to be dry. That's the whole issue. And so people end up going and looking at some of these overpriced. I think the hiking boots are so expensive because maybe it's a bigger demand in hiking. But I want you to think about golf shoes. They're waterproof. They're designed to walk on grass, obviously wet grass. And so I think you should try it out. I'm trying it out, and I'll let you know. I'll give you an update. I'm going to test it out today, and I'll give you an update in the future. Until then, this is Darnell at Freedom MMC. Peace.